Okay, so Duffy, she had a really big hit called Mercy.
Yeah, can you look up the song Mercy real quick? Duffy, D-U-F-F-Y.
Right.
Mercy, M-E-R-C-Y.
Mm-hmm. Great song. She had a great voice. And she
just
kind
real
of,
quick, a small snippet. Sorry, I didn't mean to
interrupt.
No,
you. It's okay. She won a Grammy, and she kind of just vanished. That song came out in 2011. That was her last like public appearance.
It was a good song, too. I liked it.
Really good song.
Catchy as hell.
And so she has... Did you have the song?
No, he doesn't.
Okay.
I was just checking with him.
Okay, cool.
Like, you got it? No?
So
yeah?
Go
ahead, sorry.
No, it's okay. So she's reemerged, and basically she says that during her hiatus, she was drugged, raped, and kidnapped.
Right. Well, real quick, before you go into deeper, everybody probably doesn't remember, or they kind of do, so here's a quick reminder of the song. Here we go. Okay, good. That's enough. You know.
Yeah.
You got me begging for mercy.
Yeah.
And that's kind of ironic, right?
Why won't you release me?
I know.
And it says that she was raped and drugged and held captive over some days.
I mean, were they reenacting the song?
It's crazy.
It's creepy.
And so she says she's going to do, basically she hasn't posted anything on Instagram since 2017. She doesn't tell us like exactly when or where the crime happened, but says that the details will be coming shortly. She discussed the whole ordeal with a journalist, and the interview is going to be coming out in the following weeks. And she basically said, if you have any questions, I would like to answer them in the spoken interview if I can.
Yeah.
I have a sacred love and sincere appreciation for your kindness over the years. You've been friends, and I want to thank you for that. Basically saying this to our, like, our fans and stuff.
Well, what's wild to me is that she was literally captured, taken away, and then she was released, but then it's like... She just didn't say anything about it at all. She didn't make a fuss about it.
Yeah. PTSD.
It didn't even, well, no, that too. But I'm just saying, like, no one even heard about her being
abducted
at all and kidnapped and taken and tortured and raped and drugged. I mean, my Lord, that's huge. You know what I'm saying? So, I mean, big ups. Man, I don't even know what to say. My condolences to her.
Yeah.
That's so terrible.
She says,
my Lord.
She says, you wonder why I did not choose to use my voice to express my pain. She's like, I didn't want to show the world the sadness in my eyes. She said, I asked myself, like, how can I sing from the heart if it's broken? And she's like, slowly it's becoming unbroken. So
now, is this was after her debut album, correct?
Yep.
So she went, did this song, and then all of a sudden, poof, she was just Puff the Magic Dragon gone.
Yeah.
Like Ghost. And then she reemerged. But how long she was? How many days? How long was she?
Well,
you know what I'm saying. Was like she was on tour, and then all of a sudden, like they just ganked her real quick. You know what I'm saying? They deboed her in some sort of way. Like how?
Well, the
did
timeline,
this all go down?
The timeline 2008, excuse me, is when her first album came out, Rock Fairy, which has the song Mercy on it. Her second album came out in 2011, and then I don't know if. And then that was that. She hadn't come up with any more music. They said that the last thing she posted on Instagram was in 2017. So I don't know if the incident took place between 2011 and 2017 or if it took place between 2017 and now.
Wow.
It doesn't say. I guess when she does the interview, all these details will come out. But I can totally see that being an incident that you're not like running to the forefront with.
Yeah.
It's definitely a life change, like something that's going to like totally alter and take a toll on your life. She's probably spent years in therapy, time healing and coming to grips with what happened to her. And I mean, they did a great job of keeping it private.
Yeah, I mean, obviously, on top of it, it wasn't like she was, no disrespect to Duffy at all, but it wasn't like she was Beyonce or something like that. She just had a huge hit and then she just kind of fell back.
Right.
Now, her falling back, everyone's sitting there, not everybody's sitting there going, oh, what happened to said chick or said person? Because in a way, it's kind of like Meghan Trainor came out of nowhere after that too.
Right.
And they're kind of in the same
similar
realm.
Spaces.
So it's like you kind of forget that You see what I'm saying? It's kind of like, oh, well, so that's she kind of sounds like that person. Cool. And then you just move on. You don't think, whatever happened to Duffy?
Right.
You know, you're just like, oh, there was just that one hit wonder. You know what I mean? She had a really great track.
And she
then,
had a couple
and
albums. I'm sure she has her fans or whatever that.
Yeah.
And then also, like, some artists just do, like, some artists are like this where they, like, even Adele is like that. Of course, she's much more of a bigger, a larger star. But she's a type that does a song and then she disappears.
Right.
You don't see or hear from her.
Well,
she lives her life in.
True.
You know what I'm saying?
Well, some people might think Adele has been abducted because half her body's gone.
Oh. Well, yeah, that's a whole nother thing. But for sure.
Like, her whole body's been snatched.
Yes. That's where the term comes from. Snatch that waist.
Like, bang, gone.
Yes, yes, you know what snatched. I'm saying?
But of course, you know, our thoughts and prayers go out to
Duffy
and A, being strong like that. And honestly, it takes a lot of balls to get out there and say something like this and come out and say, this is what happened to me and everything. So I'm looking forward to, you know, for a fact that I'll be tuning in to that interview, or at least whenever it gets on the internets and stuff, because I be nosy and stuff. You know what I'm saying?
P-A-S-C-A-L. You are now rocking with that dude, Pascal. We be going wild.